you later. I'm a heat seeker, I'm a game changer. Making my moves now, pushing that beta. When I lock in, things just click. Can't afford to quit when you hit and never miss. Give a little wink, blow a little kiss. You know it's all love when it's rolling like this. If you really want it, then you get it. Treating every day like the sun is never setting. If you really want it, then you better go and get it. If you wanna
Connect. My name is Liz, and I've been hosting We Days for quite a while now, and I've really enjoyed seeing how committed this generation is to inspiring each other and making a difference. And that's what today is all about, being able to share your interests and your commitment to the causes you care about with each other. Now, for those of you who may not know what exactly We Day is, it's about celebration, inspiration, and finding the motivation to get doing, just like the back of my jacket says. So, but that, what exactly does it mean to get doing? Well, all of us with our unique identities, passions, and beliefs make up what we call the We Generation. When we embrace our individuality, work together, and get doing, we can make a meaningful impact. And that's what today is all about. Motivating each other to take action on causes we care about and get doing. One way we can do this is through our We School programming. Now, today we're going to hear stories of young people, school groups, and educators who are taking action through We School's campaigns and resources, and we want you to get involved too. So once the show is over, make sure you head over to we.org/weschools to see how you can get involved. Today will be just like any other We Day, but with a little twist. We have our studio audience from Renton Prep and Timber Ridge Elementary joining us today. Thank you guys for being here. And a handful of other classrooms from around the world joining us via Skype. How cool is that? Now we'll check in with them a bit later, but first I'm going to throw it over to our social media host, Kyrie Johnson. Kyrie.
Thanks, Liz. Now, one of the perks of We Day Connect is that we get to interact with those of you watching online in real time. Now, I've worked close with We for quite a while now, sharing my story as a motivational speaker and seeing firsthand the impact that We Schools programming has on schools all across the U.S. But our impact is still growing, and that's why we want to hear from you all today, all day long. So make sure you're sending your comments, your questions throughout the entire show. How do you do that, you might ask? Well, see that little comment box on the right-hand side of your screen? Your right, not my right. Teachers watching all along, I want you all to interact with us by leaving a comment. Tell us about your favorite part of the show. What inspires you? Tell us anything. And for my students, I'm guessing a lot of you already have your phone in your hand, so just go ahead and pull it out. Go ahead, whip those phones out. Let's put them to good use. Tag us on Twitter and on Instagram and use the hashtag, boom, WeMovement. We want to see all of your photos, the videos, and your tweets. Send us a pic of your class or let us know what's exciting and what's coming up next with you all. And later on, we'll be asking some questions. So get ready, because we want to know about your actions and we want you to tell us all about them. And who knows, you might see your screen, you might see this big screen come up with a comment from you. So we'll see throughout the day, okay? I'm going to throw it over to Liz once again to introduce the rest of the We Schools and the rest of the day.
Thanks so much, Kyrie. All right, this is the fun part. Let's check in with some of the schools joining us with Skype today. All right, Toronto's in the house. Toronto, what?
New York.
We've got Milan.
We've got New York. New York. We've got St. John's, Newfoundland. And London, England. Okay, the cool thing is London, England's like at nighttime. This is in the daytime. Look at you guys. You guys look so great. Oh, thank you so much for joining us for this big celebration today. Now, some of you, oh my gosh, they're so loud. It's amazing. Some of of you still may be wondering, what exactly is WE Day? Well, WE Day is a celebration of what young people can accomplish when they take the initiative to get doing. It's a showcase of WE Generation's finest. And WE Day Connect is a way to reach even more young people and show the power we have when we come together and create massive change. Now, today, you're gonna hear from schools around the world who have been making a difference through their WE School programs. The purpose of WE Schools is to empower young people to discover issues they are passionate about, and through service, learning resources, develop a plan to actually make a difference. Then they get the opportunity to share their impacts at events like WE Day. And they're making these impacts through WE campaigns like WE Walk for Water, providing clean water access to people all over the world, because unfortunately, not everyone has it. WE Are Silent, raising awareness for those without a voice. And WE Are One, creating a more accessible world for all. These impacts have a global reach, including in our WE villages, where WE employ the five pillars of impact. So it's food, opportunity, education, health, and clean water to uplift these communities. This is just a fraction of what the WE organization can accomplish with your impacts. Let's take a closer look.
Doable or not doable?
Get out of here!
A mother kicked out for breastfeeding.
Hey, got a film permit?
The world is full of things they say are not doable. But here's what they don't tell you. Things are not doable until suddenly they are.
Wheelchair footwear!
In fact, there's a whole movement of people creating good in the world in ways that aren't supposed to be doable. They told her a girl from Chicago couldn't grow up to be an astronaut. They told her she had no place in fashion.
There's beauty in everything.
They told him he couldn't climb a mountain without legs.
Anything is possible.
Our movement started when a 12-year-old was told he could not make a difference, and he refused to take no for an answer.
Why you?
Why not?
Soon, students were raising their hands to get involved.
A local school is helping children in India receive an education.
Companies join the fight.
This accounting firm is fundraising for clean water in Ecuador.
Families came together.
This family just took a trip of a lifetime and helped build a school while doing it.
And consumers discovered they could make a real impact through simple daily choices.
It's called Track Your Impact. Just type in the code to see the difference you're making.
So what good do you want to do?
Let's do it. Let's change the game.
Do the stuff that you love doing and make it help other people.
Because WE makes doing good doable.
All right, now let's meet our first school. We're going to hear from St. Hope Leadership Academy in New York. They've come up with a pretty creative and healthy way to uplift their community. Let's take a look.
Our students are energetic, enthusiastic, inquisitive. They're student citizens. They actively make a choice to recycle, to compost. And that in itself is inspiring our students to make different choices, to expand their horizons, and make sustainable choices starting with themselves.
Harlem Grown is a farming program that produces fruits and vegetables, helps our environment and our community.
The first time the students went to Harlem Grown, they felt excited. And that feeling was tangible. There were smiles, there was laughter. This sense of eagerness to roll up their sleeves, get their hands dirty, to plant, to harvest, to create compost from the food that they're actually taking from the cafeteria. It is a real sense of joy to see a product that you have created from beginning to end, which is exactly what happens at the farm.
As a member of the green team, what we do is we collect trays, we sort it out in different kinds of bins, and then we take it to the farm and put it in soil so crops can grow.
What I've learned from the activities at Harlem Grown is to start composting, put your garbage in the right bins, so then our world could just keep on going and exceed.
The students we work with gain a lot of different types of skills that are applicable to the world beyond farming. They gain leadership skills and they're empowered by doing all of these different activities. All of our kids are empowered through their individuality and they're empowered to explore their curiosity and they're empowered to feel comfortable in who they are.
Harlem Grown has taught me in many ways
how to be a leader of change. Because change starts small. It starts with me, me as a whole. And I can make it grow bigger and bigger until we have a whole community backing us up on that change that we want to create.
I am so impressed. Now joining me from St. Hope Leadership Academy is educator Megan and her students. Hi, everyone.
Hi.
Hi. Oh, you guys are so awesome. The work you're doing together is so great. And it's a great example of how the power young people have. Now, it's also great to have teachers who want to help you grow your potential. Megan, let's dive right in. Tell us why you chose to get your students involved with Harlem Grown.
It's all about relevance and relationships. Harlem Grown is relevant to us for two reasons. One, it's less than a block away. The majority of our scholars walk by Harlem Grown either on their way to or from school every single day. The second reason it's relevant to us is our scholars wanted healthier food options in their cafeteria. Fast forward a few years, and our scholars have built a tremendous relationship with Harlem Grown. They regularly volunteer in the garden, and Harlem Grown also comes to our school.
Wow. Well, it's clear to see the incredible impact Harlem Grown has had on its volunteers. Now, students, before getting involved with this organization, what did you think you would achieve or learn through your volunteer work?
When I first started volunteering in my cafeteria and at Harlem Grown, I was simply looking forward to the joy of helping others. However, I soon realized my volunteer work was more than that. I learned the impact of recycling and composting, and that has influenced my ways beyond Harlem Grown. In addition, I learned how to better care for my school community, my local community, and my world.
Good for you.
When I first started volunteering in Harlem Grown in the cafeteria, I knew I would help my community. I knew there were better options, but I didn't know what those better options were or how they would make my community greener. But I also knew that I would learn skills that would help me in my life, own life, and in the future.
Well, now this garden has not only impacted each of you, but your community as well. So tell us more about the direct impact your recycling, composting, and gardening has had locally.
When I see people in my community litter or throw away materials that could be recycled, I see it in a different way now. I used to barely notice it. Now I know the impact of those choices in our community and our world. Since we are directly involved in composting and see how it is used in the garden, it is rewarding to know that our work in the cafeteria and in the garden is being used to make fresh produce and healthier options in our local community. Recently, they added a composting and recycling area in my building, something that has never been done before. Now people near me can compost and recycle on a daily basis.
So great. Well, did I already say how impressed I am with you guys or what? I definitely did because you're awesome. Your WE group created something from start to finish, taking recycled lunch scraps and growing produce from it. What was the biggest lesson you learned about yourselves throughout your change-making journey?
The biggest lesson I learned is that you don't have to be an adult to make a difference. I learned that with the smallest act of kindness can profoundly affect others and make our community a better place. Most importantly, I learned that I can do anything I set my mind to. It simply takes hard work and dedication to get the job done.
You're so sweet. That's amazing. All right, St. Hope, I think it's time to test your change-making skills with a game. Are you guys in?
Yeah!
Yeah, you are. Okay, let's do this. There's a whiteboard under three of your seats. Take a quick peek. I'm going to ask you a question, and you all have 10 seconds to guess the correct answer. Write an answer on each whiteboard and place them face down when you're done. Now, make sure your answers are all different. You got that?
Yes.
Okay, are you ready?
Yeah.
Yeah, you do. Okay, let's do this. Name three WE school campaigns. The first should focus on water, the second on food, and the last on taking a vow. Okay, time's up. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, flip those boards over. What do we have here? All right, we got we walk for water, we scare hunger, and we are silent. Perfect. Congratulations. And more importantly, for all the work that you're doing to make a difference in your community. So we has a special surprise for you. Do you like surprises?
Yes.
Look at that. We would like to donate gardening tools to your WE group so that you can start your very own school garden. How exciting is that?
Yeah.
Now, we cannot wait to see what else your incredible group will accomplish this year. Thank you so much for joining us today and for inspiring us with all that you're doing to make a change. Keep up the great work, guys. Bye.
Bye.
Thanks, St. John Hope Leadership Academy, for joining us today. Wasn't that community garden amazing? It was like breathtaking. Now, teachers and students watching along, we have to hear from you. We really want to hear from you. What are some other cool ways we can create healthier communities? Or tell us about the initiatives your school or your group has been taking to make a difference locally in your community or in your school. Now, comment in that box to the right of your screen. Remember, it's your right, my left. Yeah. And make sure you tag us on social media at WE Movement, right? We'll be reading out some of those responses later, so keep them coming, keep them coming. You can tag us on social media with the hashtag WE Movement, okay? Tag us in comments, photos, videos, GIFs or GIFs. What are, kids, are they GIFs? GIFs? The GIFs? GIFs? Yeah. The young people know. You might end up seeing some of them on the screen a little bit later on. So after all, we can make the biggest difference when we work together. Now, let's take a look at how the WE Movement gets doing both at home and all around the world.
Hey, WE Day, it's Johnny Orlando, and I want to give a huge shout out to everyone watching online who is helping to change the world. There's actually one school that I want to highlight right now, Northwood Middle School in Washington. In the past year, they've participated in their city's local suicide prevention walk, raising awareness and funds around such an important cause. But they didn't stop there. They also took part in We Are Silent Together, and continue to stand for anti-bullying, LGBTQ plus rights, environmental issues, and so much more. They're proof that every individual can create change, but when we come together as a community, we can make a massive impact. So, I want every young person watching today to think about how you can work with your teachers, parents, and friends to make as big an impact as possible. Dream big, we day.
Who is a part of the WE movement, whether it's WE schools, taking part in a campaign, or even just watching WE Day connect right now, it really helps make that impact possible. So thank you. All right, I think it's time we have a little fun here in the studio. You guys want to play a game or something?
Yes.
Okay. We're going to play a game of true or false. So I need some help from this audience in here. I think you guys got this. You ready for this? Okay, you're dedicated. I like that. Okay, the game is pretty simple. I'm going to ask you a true or false question, and I want you to hold up your sign with the correct answer. Got it?
Yeah.
All right, the first question. WE Villages makes a difference in global communities through 5 pillars of impact. Is that true or false? You guys make me so proud. Yes, it is. The answer is true. Education, water, health, food, and opportunity. All right, next question. Great job, guys. Craig Kielburger, the co-founder of WE, started this organization as a 12-year-old. True or false? You were questioning it, but you got it right. This is true. Now, the last one. There are less than 5,000 WE schools around the globe. True or false? Yours is upside down. I like you. All right. The answer is false. Good job, guys. There are more than 12,000 WE schools around the world empowering students every day with school programs and leadership opportunities. Great job. You made me proud. All right, everybody, I'm going to throw it over to my co-host in Toronto, Marika, who is with another inspiring group of students that are making a difference in their community. Take it away, Marika.
Thanks, Liz. Now, how many of you have ever had a spark of an idea that you thought could make a difference? Maybe your idea will help brighten your community or shed light on people in need.
Can we stand up?
Maybe your idea will re-energize environmental programs or bring a brighter future to youth just like you. Through RBC's Future Launch Initiative with WE, we're helping to spark a generation of social innovators with a really exciting program. We are social entrepreneurs.
I have an idea.
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 Ideas. We all have them. Big ideas, little ideas, human ideas, revolutionary ideas. Ideas that should be shared, but lacking the courage to share or not knowing how to make them real can leave us feeling powerless. That's why RBC created Future Launch, our commitment to helping youth get ready for the fast-changing world of tomorrow. In partnership with WE, RBC Future Launch developed the We Are Social Entrepreneurs program. It provides mentorship, business basics, and support to help turn your idea for social change, whether big or small, into a reality. Ideas like Asala's. With the help of RBC and WE, she is creating an app and a website that connects lower-income families with businesses willing to offer products and services they wouldn't be able to afford. Could your idea be the next to affect social change? Can your idea shine just as brightly?
I had an idea.
Now, to share more about her experience with We Are Social Entrepreneurs, please join me in welcoming Asala Youssef. Now, Asala, just like we saw in the video, you have an idea. Mm-hmm. Tell us a little bit more about it.
My business idea is called the R&R Place, which stands for the Radical and Revolutionary Place. It's going to be an app and website where socially conscious businesses can offer their product, service, or experience for a discounted price or free to low-income Canadians.
That's wonderful. Thank you. And what was your experience like working with the We Are Social Entrepreneurship Program in bringing your idea to life?
Working with the We Are Social Entrepreneurs program was so empowering for me because I learned skills such as marketing, building a business plan, financial literacy, and I also got to speak with the most incredible people, such as RBC mentors who helped just take my idea to the next level. And at the end of the week, I recognized how much my business idea expanded, but I also noticed a change in myself. I came back from the week feeling so confident that I, as a youth, can make my idea a reality.
I love that. Why is it so important for young people to have resources and opportunities that will help them make their ideas come a reality?
There are many issues in the world that are just simply not being addressed well enough. And because youth are the future business owners, knowing how to be social entrepreneurs is so vital.
Yes, I completely agree. Now, what advice do you have for other young innovators who are trying to get started?
Start by writing all of your ideas down. Don't dismiss any, don't filter, just write them all down because you never know what can come out of the idea that you didn't think was so good. And then start researching. Find out your why. Why do you want to help this cause? And then reach out to someone who supports you and ask for their guidance. And keep being proactive. Keep seeking out opportunities and find out more and talk to as many people as you can. And lastly, know that your idea is neither too small or too big and that it is worthy. And know that, and just think about that, the people and or what you're going to impact by making your idea happen.
Thank you so much for sharing with us today, Asala. Now, I've been told that we have some more young innovators in the audience with us today.
We do. Representing her group, GPCI City, please welcome Akila Laidley. With an amazing social enterprise called YYZ Inbound Initiative. Tell us more about it.
Okay. So I'm a part of a student group called GPCI City. City stands for Change Impacting Toronto's Youth, and we work on various projects and initiatives that help our local and global community. One of the projects is our YYZ product line. Initially, it started 3 years ago as a way to help support the newcomers that were coming to Canada. So we use the funds from the product line to create pencil cases, and also in the pencil case included was a USB that had a message from the mayor, the prime minister, and also information on how to get around Toronto.
One innovative way to help such an important cause. So where do you hope to take your enterprise in the future?
With the support of like mentors, friends, and family, we hope to expand our business and also have all payment and purchasing done online or even get into a store.
What you're doing is so amazing, and I can't wait to see what incredible things you and GPCI City do next.
Thank you.
Thank you, Akila, for sharing your experience with us. Mm-hmm. And thank you, Asala, for sharing your journey with us. We're so excited to see where you continue to go. Now, Akila, we know that your group is holding your fundraiser this evening, mm-hmm. correct?
Yeah.
Amazing. So, to congratulate you on all your hard work and help further your project, RBC is donating $1,500 to your fundraising effort. Isn't that amazing? Now, are you all ready to share your ideas? Visit we.org/WASE to sign up for a We Are Social Entrepreneurs conference taking place near you. You can gather with like-minded youth, mentors, and experts to help bring your ideas for social good to life. Make sure to register today. Thank you.
Hey everyone, I'm Millie Davis, and I'm so excited to give a special shout out to one standout school who's making a difference. So to every teacher and student at Norman Ingram School in Toronto, thank you. Norman Ingram School started a WE Club last month in memory of a teacher who passed away at their school. They just completed their We Scare Hunger campaign, where the students had a goal of collecting 1,000 pounds of food and surpassed their goal by creating a school-wide competition. They've come together as a community during a tough time and have done so much good in the process. Norman Ingram, you're a true inspiration. And for everybody watching along today, we want to hear your stories of change as well. Make sure you reach out to us at We Movement and tell us how you're making an impact.
It is so inspiring to know that you all can make a difference by finding a cause you care about and know with hard work and dedication, you can achieve great things. I'm going to throw it over to my co-host Amanda in St. John's, Newfoundland, who is with a group of students who are tackling an issue that many of us have today
for young people. And it's probably something that all of you have either witnessed or experienced. Through our We Rise Above campaign, you can use the hashtag #EndBullying to take a stand and end bullying for good. We'd like to take a moment to share a story with you about two sisters, Maya and Eden, who are TELUS ambassadors, who have a different perspective on cyberbullying and took the opportunity to rise above. Let's check it out.
We should start by telling you, we're twins. You can probably imagine.
We do a lot of stuff together.
We are both guilty of spending too much time online, mostly following celebrities and looking at slime videos. But recently, we did something we are not proud of. We bullied someone.
There was a group of popular girls at our school that we really wanted to be friends with. They always seemed to be laughing and having a fun time. We really wanted to be accepted by them.
We came up with an idea to start a group chat with them. We didn't really know what to talk about, so we started saying mean things about a new girl, who we actually really liked.
We called her weird and lame, we made fun of her clothes, and we also shared a bad photo of her.
At first it felt good because the other girls thought it was funny, but as time went on, something felt very wrong.
It was so easy to type mean things online that we didn't even realize what we were doing, but we were bullying.
One night we came clean. We talked to each other about it and to our mom about how we could make changes.
We had never thought of ourselves as bullies. It felt awful. Coming to this realization made us want to make a positive change, to rise above the negativity and help others rise above too.
Now we are good friends with the girl we bullied, and we try to help others. We make it our mission to help new kids feel accepted.
I'm part of a leadership program that works to make my school more accepting and inclusive for all. And I've stood up and intervened when I saw a group bullying a girl at my school.
We've learned that being kind is way cooler than being popular. That's why we're here alongside TELUS. We want every kid in Canada to know that we all have the power to stand up to cyberbullying, even the ones doing the bullying.
Together, let's rise above to end bullying.
What a courageous example of how we can all rise above and end bullying together. Here with me, I have two other incredible individuals who are taking actions to end cyberbullying. I have Daniel Blackmore and Sylvia Ivardi from McDonald Junior High School in St. John's, Newfoundland. So let's hear from you two. What are the amazing initiatives that you've been working on? I know that you've had over 10 WE campaigns over the last year, which is incredible, and you've taken initiatives to end cyberbullying. Daniel, can you let me know about those initiatives?
Okay, so first of all, late last year, we attended a screening of a film called Rising Above, which featured the 10 stories of students from across Canada and how they dealt with either being bullied or being bullies. After that, we followed up with an in-class activity. We had a pink shirt day, followed with pink cupcakes to prevent bullying. And we also did a cyberbullying and internet safety unit in social studies.
That's amazing. Incredible. We know that to end cyberbullying, one of the things we need to focus on is inclusive and safe spaces. Sylvie, can you tell me a little bit more about that?
Yes. So inclusive spaces are extremely important because they help people feel safe. Several teachers have noticed students walking around by themselves during recess and lunch, and they decided to change that. So various spaces around the school were open, so these students had some place to go. One of these spaces is the guidance room. People can come in, chat, hang out, or just relax. And this space is open during recess and lunch to anyone. We also have the Fun Club, which stands for Friends of the United Nations. People can come in, socialize, meet new friends, and learn about diverse cultures.
That's incredible. I love that, all the amazing actions that you're taking to make people feel included. Wonderful. Now, we saw with the example from Maya and Eden a different perspective on cyberbullying. Daniel, what advice would you give to someone going through a similar situation?
I would advise them to talk to a teacher or parent about it and remember that everybody deserves a second chance.
Amazing. One of the things I like to think about with bullying is that people participate in bullying, but people aren't bullies. So that really gives them a second chance. So what are you going to do next? What next for the We Rise Above campaign?
So in December, we will once again participate in our digital citizenship and safety online lessons using the social studies curriculum resources. This year, we will be hosting our very first full-day GSA conference, which stands for Gender Sexuality Alliance. Last year, we had a half-day after-school conference, and it received so much positive feedback that teachers decided to organize this one. This day will promote acceptance of gender and sexual orientation and will be a celebration of difference so that all students feel safe to express their true selves. Lastly, we will be having, once again, our Pink Shirt Day, but we'd like to expand on our message. In addition to wearing pink and eating pink cupcakes, we would like each class to complete the TELUS Anti-Bullying Pledge, and we will be receiving lessons from the Digital Citizenship Unit from We Rise Above Curriculum Resources. Once again, students will be asked to send random messages of kindness using the hashtag MBJHRiseAbove.
That's amazing. Let's give a huge round of applause for the work that we're doing here. And we want to honor you for all of the wonderful work that you're doing. So we actually have a surprise for you from TELUS to donate $1,500 towards your fundraising initiatives this year. Amazing. And all of you at home can stop bullying as well. Go to we.org/endbullying to take the pledge today to end bullying for good. Now that you've heard about all of the incredible things happening here in Newfoundland, let's hear about some other impacts that are happening from youth around the world.
Yeah, I got your back. Are you on your feet? We can work it out. Will you dance with me? Every single night.
Right now, there's so many of you tuning in right now from all over the world, including Saudi Arabia, Spain, India, Trinidad and Tobago, just to name a few places. How awesome is that? Now we're going to read some of those responses that you all are sending in. Let's take a look here. All right. And it looks like we got Jennifer Harrell for Ralston School connected for the first time with We Day Connect, hashtag We Movement. Yeah, thank you all for coming in, tuning in. Stay tuned. We got MLA Peer GDSB. They have We Day Connect 2018, grades 4 through 6, middle school love. Hashtag Boom We Movement, hashtag GDS Bobs. Okay, hashtag We Movement. Look at them, there's so many of them in that room. Yes, they're deep. I love it. We also got another post right here from Kush Ginger 5. Ooh, they are ready. They are turned. Hashtag We Movement at Ren Prep. Shout out to Ren Prep. Oh, is that me? This is so creepy to look at a picture of me. Look at a picture. That's ridiculous. We got another post from our friend Darlene_SG. Hashtag We Movement at Country Hills 1. So happy to live stream this inspirational program. Hashtag Art words be cares. Okay. I like this. Thank you for tuning in. You said it's inspirational. Oh, it's touching. Let's see what we got over here. We have we got a post from the Mr_T. That's cool. Signed into We Day Connect, hashtag We Movement. Look at them. They are living life. I love it. They got really good decorations in their room. We have another post from Miss Arnold's Kiddos. Look at you. You make good names. Shout out to Miss Arnold's. Now, they have a post right here of them in the classroom watching it. It looks like they're having fun. Hashtag We Movement. That's the hashtag. Watching We Connect webcast, so exciting. So literally, people around the world are all tuning in right now. Do we have any more? We good? Okay, perfect. Now keep those coming in because you don't know which ones we're going to pull up there. So thank you so much for sending those comments and keep them coming all day long. And don't forget to tag us with the hashtag WeMovement. We all want to hear what you're doing, what you're up to, what's your favorite part of the show, and everything. So keep us in tune all day. Now I'm going to throw it over to my co-host with the most. Take it away, Liz.
Thanks, Kyrie. Great job, buddy. Vanna White of the We Connect. I love that. Now, anyone who's watching with their We Schools groups knows all about our We Walk for Water campaign. But for those of you who are new to We Day, let me give you a little recap. The purpose of the We Walk for Water campaign is to raise awareness and fundraise for communities around the world that don't have access to clean water. Our goal? Well, to bring clean water access to as many communities as possible. In April, we held our first ever water walk in Toronto and impacted 40,000 lives with access to clean water. So give yourselves a round of applause for that. So next year, we're hoping to go even bigger. Now we're going to check in with a school who's working to do just that. Please welcome, live via Skype, educator Kayla and her students from Jo Richardson Community School in London, England. Hello, guys.
Hi.
Hey.
You all look so great. How are you doing?
Yeah, we're doing good.
All right, well, it's so awesome to get the opportunity to talk with all of you and learn more about the incredible impacts you've all been making. So tell us more about your school's participation in We Walk for Water this year. How long was the walk? Who helped you along the way? And how much did you raise?
We have done so many silent marches in the past. One day I saw a quote in a classroom at school, and we talked about the opportunity to do our own Walk for Water. We took several students from our school and another local primary school to walk around the Serpentine in London. It was an amazing event, one that raised money and awareness.
On the day, we walked 4 kilometres in the rain. But that made it more fun, didn't it, guys?
Yeah!
And also very relevant, as it was a bit...
wet.
Yeah.
Very wet.
We raised over £790, and we purchased 1 community well, 1 farm bundle, and 3 years of healthy lunches for a student.
Wow, you guys are so awesome. Incredible job. Now, what did you learn about water access overseas, and why is it so important?
I think the main thing that we learned was the challenges that both women and children have to face just to get the right necessities. Both women and children in Africa and Asia have to walk an average of 6 kilometres every single day. Water isn't a luxury, it's a basic human right.
This is important because I believe it's crucial to learn about people's difficult ways of living, so we don't forget how hard it is for people all across the world of our age. No water?
No life.
So we must raise awareness.
Wow, you guys are incredible. So after all you learned, how did you and your classmates work together as you organized your We Walk for Water campaign, and what was the key to success?
We met once a week to plan, make posters, and get permission forms. Making our posters was very fun, and they definitely caught the attention of the public. Some people even asked us what we were doing, which made us very, very proud.
Our school is very proactive when it comes down to local and global action. We believe it is our duty as global citizens to raise awareness of homelessness, poverty, and lack of water and other important issues. We love making good doable.
And I love that. Now, this question is for you, Kayla. As an educator, do you plan on taking part in the campaign again in 2019? And if so, why?
Oh, most definitely. I first of all want to say that these guys are amazing. You know, they are caring, they are charismatic, they're leaders of the future, and I'm so proud to be their teacher. So in answer to your question, absolutely, guys, we are going to do it next year.
Yeah.
We've got one planned. We're going to go down to the South Coast and we're going to link up with a few schools down in Brighton, and we're going to have a day out at the beach and walk along the waterfront. I think what's most important for us is that young people have a voice. And when they find something that they're really passionate about, something that really drives them, then anything is possible. And I think that's evident from what we're seeing all over the globe today. So, you know, I think at JRCS, the most important thing is that we are absolutely going to keep walking. We're going to keep raising awareness. Isn't that right, Liam?
Thank you. Yeah, that's 100% right, because essentially no matter how long it takes, no matter how hard we have to work, we are never going to stop walking until we've gotten our point across.
Cool. I just want to finish, guys, with handing over to Sahana, please.
We believe water isn't a luxury, it's a basic human need. So why is there 780 million people around the globe who don't have access to clean water? As a collective, we can change that statistic through raising awareness, charity, and our campaigns like this. We hope we inspired you to make that change. Thank you.
Well, you definitely inspired me, guys. Thank you so much. And give it up for your educator, Kayla. Great job. You've got an incredible group of students. Yeah. What a great initiative. Now, we can't wait to see what you achieve together during the next We Walk for Water campaign. So we're excited to give you 100 water rafikis as a fundraising tool for your next campaign. How cool is that?
So cool. That is so cool. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Joe Richardson School. Now, We Day Connect, we have a special surprise for all of you. Here is the world premiere of this year's We Walk for Water campaign.
We walk 2.5 hours every day to the river to get water for our families.
We walk with 40-pound jerry cans filled with water strapped to our backs.
We walk this journey 5 times a day, carrying children and sometimes with firewood on our head.
We walk to a river source that is not clean and can sometimes cause illness and diseases to spread in our families.
We walk to this river and collect the same water that our livestock drinks from.
We walk because we need this water to cook, clean, and drink.
We walk because this is our only water source.
But we're the generation who can change this.
We walk so girls can go to school instead of to the river.
We walk so families can break the cycle of poverty.
On May 10th, join the global movement to provide our We Villages communities with access to clean water.
$25 provides one person access to clean water for life.
Now that is some incredible work. We've seen how big of an impact you've all made in the past with the We Walk for Water campaign, and we can't wait to see what you accomplish in 2019. Now, we know that addressing the pressing issues facing our generation will require solutions that are innovative, collaborative, and powered by technology to help advance a future that is for everyone. With Microsoft and the We Are One campaign, young people like John and Christian are using their digital skills, inclusive design, and compassion to create that future. Let's take a look at their story.
Jersey was my home. Leaving was hard, but it was definitely harder for my brother, Christian. He had to leave his group of friends and kind of start fresh here.
My brother, he made an app called You Belong.
You Belong is a free social network for people with differing abilities and their families. The idea for the app came as a way for us to make new friends. My brother's the number one beta tester. He tells me what he wants, and I'll make sure it gets in there.
Today is a perfect example of how you can use the app in order to meet other people, all different ages, and get together and just be themselves and have fun.
It's great to see technology allowing everybody to connect, and it makes me feel proud that we were able to create something so awesome.
I have so many friends thanks to You Belong.
To tell us more about creating a more inclusive world through technology, please welcome the head of Microsoft Philanthropies, Mary Snap, and brothers John and Christian Sioka.
Thanks, everybody. Thank you, Liz. It is just so wonderful to have all of you tuning in online. I'm so excited about that. And I'm also excited to have John and Christian with us today. Thanks, you guys, for coming.
We're so glad to be here.
Good. Well, now, we're just so honored to tell the story, to help you tell the story about how technology can bring people together and at the same time empower people to work on issues that they care the most about. And we've already seen the incredible app that you guys have developed, the You Belong app. And so can you tell us just a little bit more about what made you want to start creating apps for good?
I wanted to come up with a way for Christian, his friends, and other people with disabilities to be able to connect in a safe environment online, especially free from cyberbullying. And while it took a few years for the You Belong app to take shape, accessibility and inclusion is something that has always meant a lot to me and my family.
That's just great, John. And now, Christian, what was it like to work with your brother?
It's been so much fun. John asked me what I want for the app. So we come with ideas together. It's great that I can help him.
And you know, they say that teamwork makes dream work. So John, coming back to you now, have you always been interested in computer coding and computer science?
I haven't really thought about it, but it didn't really come as a shock. I've always had this inventive nature growing up. I love building things with Legos or whatever I could really find, and taking things apart to see how they work. So computer science wasn't initially what I thought I'd be doing, but I'm glad I've been able to use my skills to make a difference.
That's great. And you know, it can be kind of scary for people who don't know much about it. So do you have any advice for the students who are listening online who might want to get interested in computer science and coding and don't know where to start?
There's so many resources available online, videos, tutorials, you name it. It might seem intimidating at first, but just go ahead and give it a shot. Even if it's not something you do in the long run, it'll give you problem-solving skills and you'll learn so much. Plus, it's a lot of fun.
Well, couldn't have said that better myself. So tell me, what's next for you guys?
We want to get more people using our app, but we're also working on a new project.
Yeah, we're still in the designing stages, but it's going to focus on AI for accessibility.
Wow, that's just amazing. You guys are so amazing, aren't they? Audience, yes? Absolutely. Now, before you go, we want more young people to work in computer science and technology. And so, as a gift to you, John, whenever you're ready, Microsoft will pay for 5 exam fees for you to get certificates on cool new computer science projects.
That's awesome.
And in honor of both of you, Christian, we are also honored to make a gift of $2,500 to a charity that we know is very special to both of you, the Bring Up Down Syndrome.
Yep.
And we know that that will help them continue to do important work for young people with Down syndrome. So congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.
Hey, turn around.
Oh, I turned it the wrong way. That's great, you guys. We can't wait to see what you do next.
Wow, what an incredible initiative. This is a real example of how it doesn't matter how old we are or what our talents may be, we can always use them to create a more inclusive world for everyone. Give it up one more time for John and Christian. Yeah. And we haven't forgotten all about you online. If you're as inspired as I am by John and Christian, check out we.org/weareone to register for our campaign, as well as find resources and lesson plans to help make your school and community more inclusive. Then submit your application for a chance to win one of five $1,000 grants from Microsoft to help you make to help make your plan a reality. Who knows? Maybe next year you'll be up here sharing your story. Now I'd love to hear from I'd love to hear about what you think about John and Christian's project. So you guys, Emmy, do you want to come up and talk to me? Come on up, girl. Awesome. Okay, so Emmy, why do you think using technology for good is just so important?
Well, I think it's important to understand and acknowledge the privileges that we have and how we're so lucky to have access to technology. So it's important that we share what we have to people who don't have a lot of access and benefit their lives.
Absolutely. We're united. We're a united force. We have to stick together. Thanks so much, Emmy. Great job. All right, totally. So, we've got another Wii School shout out from one of our friends. Let's check it out.
How's it going, everybody? Connor Franta here, hoping you're all having a great time watching We Day Connect. A big theme of the day is making impacts for global change, and that's why I want to take a second to shout out an amazing school in the United Kingdom who is creating change, the Regis School. Students there started a group called the Rights Respecting Ambassadors and decided to take part in the We Walk for Water event together. Since it takes 15 pounds to provide clean water to someone for life, they chose to walk 15 miles along the southern coast of England. The group made water pots similar to the ones used in India and carried three throughout the walk, taking turns to swap and share the load. They raised enough funds to provide clean water access to over 60 people in We Village communities. Regis School, thank you for making such an amazing impact. And for everyone else watching along, I want you to think about what causes you care about and how you're going to create positive change. Thanks, We Day.
Yeah. All right. I think it's time for another game. Now, I have with me Mr. Blakely and Mr. Marius. Won't you all say hello to the people?
Hello.
Hi. Sweet. So I'm going to ask you all some We Day trivia. And I want you to try and guess the correct answer, okay?
Okay.
Perfect. First question, how many pounds of food were collected by youth for local food banks? A, 200 million, B, 40.8 million, C, 23.3 million, or D, 11.5 million? You can just shout it out or I can hold it. What are you thinking? What are you thinking?
C.
C?
C too.
You going C? The answer is C! Congratulations! Give me some noise for them, yes! 23.3 million. Y'all are smart. You've been paying attention. Context clues. I like you too. Next question. Who said this at We Day? The powerful weapon you have is your voice. All right? A, Malala Yousafzai. B, Lily Singh. C, Selena Gomez. Or D, Lily Collins. Now, this is tricky, so take a second. What do you think?
A.
Okay. Teamwork makes the dream work. We're going to go A. It is Malala. Good job. Make some noise for them. Good job. What? Y'all know everything. You ready to get a job at Wii? This is beautiful. Next question. How many hours did youth commit to volunteering for local and global causes? A, 5 million, B, 70.3 million, C, 20.5 million, or D, 46.4 million?
D.
You gonna go D?
Yeah.
D too? Wow. Can't get nothing over him. D is right, 46.4 million. That is a lot of hours, y'all.
Yeah.
Thank you. That's amazing. Now, we have one more question. Now, who said this at We Day? Just knowing that you have a bigger role to play, not just for yourself, but for others, that is what greatness is. A, Martin Luther King III. B, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. C, Peter Mansbridge. Or D, Shawn Mendes. Take a second, think about it. No pressure, no pressure, no pressure, no pressure, no pressure. Y'all have gotten everything right so far, no pressure, no pressure.
B.
B?
C.
C. And the answer is B, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. Put your hands together, they're doing a great job up there. What? Right, can we get another round of applause for them? They just did this on live TV. Oh, it's amazing. Now, earlier we saw Joe Richardson School receive 100 water Rafikis to help them with their fundraising goals. That's amazing. But Rafikis are so much more than a fundraising tool or a fashionable bracelet. They are a key with the ability to unlock so many opportunities for families and communities way overseas. And the best part? They are deeply intertwined with our local culture and respecting the past while building the future. Let's take a look.
A Maasai woman's life is written in beads. Red is the strength of our sacred animals. Blue symbolizes energy. Green is for the land that sustains us. Yellow is growth and opportunity.
It started with one beaded piece, a wedding gift from the Maasai mamas I'd been working with for years. Could this be a new source of income and empowerment for these women?
It started with a handful of mamas. We wanted to connect with women around the world, so we called it Rafiki, meaning friend.
It started with one village, but it's grown into a global movement.
This is a Rafiki.
In the Swahili word, friend.
It's handmade with love.
By women artisans in Kenya.
Each Rafiki is funding access to clean water, healthcare, food and education.
I'm gonna show you a really cool way to wear your Rafiki
bracelet, necklace,
anklet.
Slowly, we began to earn four times what we used to.
1,400 women employed.
We're doing it, we're doing it.
Because we are in
this together.
Today we broke a record.
Most bracelets.
In one day.
In one day.
Me Too We artisans are establishing themselves as business leaders while lifting their families and communities out of poverty, one bracelet at a time.
A Maasai woman's life is written in beads. And bead by bead, we are rewriting our future.
Please, please, check out we.org/wearerafikis to learn more about Rafikis and how you can get your own. All right, now, you've all been tagging us in some awesome posts on Twitter and the Instagram, and I think it's time we check out some more of them, Why don't you come over to my big pretty board with me, So, it looks like we have a post here from Daniel Foot, Hampton Middle School planned and fundraised our own We Day. We believe, wow, we raised over $2 million, what? And had 8,000 kids present and 80,000 watching live stream all across the USA and Canada. Well, Hampton Middle School, shout out to y'all. What? Can I get a dollar? That's amazing. Down here, we got another post from Ellie Gray. Hi, my name is Ellie Gray from the Manor Park Public School. Hey, girl. And currently making Rafikis for our Rafiki sale. Well, you do the thing, girl. Look at you. Yeah. Best of luck with that. Ooh, I'm so proud of y'all. Hunter Lemry. Okay. Hi, We Day. I'm here with my class at Coldwater Public School. Shout out to Coldwater Public School. We help every year on Earth Day by going on a walk through the town and picking up trash or picking up all the garbage we see. Wow, Hunter. Shout out to you, helping make the world a better place and a cleaner place, right? We got some pictures. We got one here from Much Tammy, at Much Tammy, hashtag We Movement. Look at all of my friends in there. There's so many of them. And they got, like, drinks and pizza. They are living their best life right now. Enjoy the rest of the show. Now, you all, we got another post right here from Afamia Ahalu. I hope I said that right. Oh, they're watching, and they got really comfy chairs. So it looks like we're watching We Day Connect live. Our classmates are even in the live audience. Ah, look at y'all! Excited to learn more about how we can change the world. Hashtag We Movement. Look at y'all homies right here. Yes! So that is amazing. Do we have any more? Some more coming? Oh, we do have more! Yes! Y'all are tweeting and hashtagging us. At Lucy, L. Lucy Armstrong, our school is spreading kindness and positivity by putting compliments on everyone's lockers on Pink Shirt Day, hashtag We Movement. Oh, look at y'all. Making me feel all warm and fuzzy on the inside, like a hot pocket. Ah. Next post. Sarah Schwaschka, she posts, we did it too. We did too. We collected over 590 pounds of food for the local food bank. Sarah, y'all breaking numbers over there. We partnered with Bennett Dunlop Ford. Oh, we are a small school of 110 students. 110 students just raised 590 pounds of food. That's amazing. That's the power of young people teaming up. That's beautiful. I love that. We have another post here from Varna Kiyoti. This is a nice little picture. Look at them. They look so cozy and know each other. The students are super excited watching the hashtag We Movement live. Such an inspiring and eye-opening experience. Thank you at We Movement and hashtag Microsoft EDU for offering us that great opportunity to become a part of it. Hashtag MIE expert. Wow, look at them. We have more. We're gonna break the internet. Let's do it. We're like Wreck-It Ralph. So we have at SNCDSB. They got bowl food. They're eating lunch. Look at them. They having a good time. They're watching us live at STMS_soldiers watching. Ooh, they're soldiers. Look at them. Watching hashtag We Day, sharing some great memories with friends at We Movement, hashtag SNCDSB. Look at them. They having a ball in there. Next post, SM English. Oh, I think that is a post of me. This isn't creepy at all. I love it. It looks like they're enjoying themselves. They got the chat open. It is live. So honored to be a part of the hashtag We Movement. Sending love and respect to all of the world from Saudi Arabia. Shout out to our friends all the way out there in Saudi Arabia. Hey, friends. And shout out to everyone else around the world that are tweeting. And this is amazing. Do we have any more? We have more? No? Oh, okay. But keep posting. You never know. Our show isn't over yet. So if you can still tag us on social media using that hashtag WeMovement, I love it. We want to know what has inspired you today, okay? Now, We Day Connect is all about actions young people are taking to make that difference. And since this is a global event, we have a pretty cool message in store from some of our friends way over in Kenya. We'll go ahead and check it out.
Greetings from Kisaruni School in Kenya. I'm Marcy.
I'm Joanne. And I'm Milka. We are so happy to be a part of today's amazing event. We are so excited to tell you about all the things we do with our week clubs to make our communities a better place. I am in the Culture Club, where we learn about our diverse cultures to accommodate and appreciate our different backgrounds.
I'm in the Health Club, where we learn about proper hygiene practices to attain sustainable health.
I'm in the Garden Club, where we learn about food production to attain food security back in our communities. Our actions have the potential to change lives around the globe. So let's work together to create the world we want to see. Thanks, We Day Connect.
Today we've been joined by so many incredible schools from around the world. So we'd like to thank you all one last time before you sign off.
Yes, St. Hope Leadership Academy in New York, thank you. Social Entrepreneur, Asala, thank you so much. St. Denise Catholic School, thank you. St. George Junior Public School, thank you. And John Polani Collegiate in Toronto. Ooh, way out in the six, thank you. Joe Richardson Academy all the way in the UK, thank you so much. And as well as McDonald Drive Junior High in New Finland, you thought we forgot? Thank you all too. And thank you all for watching us today.
And of course, we can't forget all of our amazing regional co-hosts, Marika and Amanda. Thank you so much for all your help today.
Finally, we can't forget all of you watching along online. thank you so much for joining us today. And we hope you had as much fun as we did. It was pretty lit.
Right? You guys had fun today, right?
I had fun.
And thank you to our audience. Today has been pretty awesome, hasn't it, Kyrie?
Oh, my jaw dropped. My heart was just, it was a lot. It was amazing. It was so amazing to hear from all the incredible WE schools and seeing how their hard work is truly making an impact, both locally and globally.
Absolutely. And if you haven't already, make sure to check out we.org/WE schools or send us an email at at weschools@we.org. I know, it's a mouthful. To get your class or school group involved. And who knows, maybe it'll be you sharing your story next year at WE Day Connect.
You never know.
Never know. Never say never.
All right, now before we sign off, we've got a pretty awesome performer here in the studio with us. Here's a hip-hop artist right here in Seattle. Let's give some love to this hometown hero. Show some love to Soul.
Yeah. Hey, how you guys doing?
We good.
You good? This song right here is called Ain't Gonna Stop. Yeah. You got me feeling so fly. Yeah, I could all night. Yeah. So the moon was high, the music was loud. I was holding on my cutie, looking you in the eye. You said, do you wanna fly? I said, do I wanna ride? Hell yeah, I've been dreaming about the sky my whole life with the girl on my arm. Yeah, the one on my left. Bumping my music up in heaven and they're loving my mix. Biggie Pac in her, me and Bob on her. I could die the day I know the deal is bobbing his head. So I work all night, and I work so hard. I might lose my mind, but I ain't gonna stop until I get mine. Nah, I ain't gonna stop till I get my shine. Won't stop till I get mine. I said I ain't gonna stop. Hey, hey, hey. Nah, I ain't gonna stop. No, no. Oh, I said I ain't gonna stop. I need you. Hey, hey, hey. Nah, I ain't gonna stop. Nah.
No.
There you go.
Oh.
Feel like the sky's in the ceiling, meaning there's no limit to the feeling that I'm feeling. Say hi, you know I'm gifted.
Hi.
Some people change and act distant. If I rearrange, is that different? I'm taking a salt break, watching a movie. One answer the phone, so don't call. Potty pumping some Coltrane, sipping some OJ. Up in the morning, my life is hard. By the bar, drinking holy water. California, California, she just wanna. But I'm flyer than an astronaut. I got feelings I can't buy to love. I just wanna love. But these girls, they just wanna crush. I'm talking good problems. I've been ducking shots. I ain't talking same problems. I ain't jacking chains, but I would rock 'em. I'ma take your spot, and I ain't stopping. Said I ain't gonna stop.
Hey, hey.
Nah, I ain't gonna stop.
No,
no. Oh, I said I ain't gonna stop.
Hey, hey, hey.
Nah, I ain't gonna stop.
No. Oh.
Now let's break it down.
Yes, clap. Hey, there we go.
All right. Let's keep it going. See, I knew you guys had soul. All right, the hook one last time, and I'm gonna need to hear you. I ain't gonna stop.
Hey, hey,
come on.
Hey,
nah, I ain't gonna stop. No,
no. Oh,
I said I ain't gonna stop.
Hey, hey, hey.
Nah, I ain't gonna stop.
No. Oh.
Thank you so much. Is it cool if we do one more song? Yeah?
Yeah!
Thank you, bro. This song is actually a world premiere, and it's called The Kids.
One,
real spit. Real, real spit. Mess around and start thinking about the kids. I ain't trying to tell nobody how to live. I just want to see you live. My fellow artists, I have an announcement to make. We have some albums to make. We have to step out the house and change our outlook today. If we gonna change the outcome tomorrow, yeah, this world is getting touched. Not the good touch that wake up and lay up and make love again. I mean, this world is getting violated. No wonder why my people's dilated. We just want peace. You don't even need a slice. You don't even eat pie. We just trying to eat right. People in the streets dying. How I'm gonna keep rhyming about rolling with my G's while these trees falling. Real spit. Real realness. I've been over fame since the homie got rich. I love making hits, but I hate what it does to my head. I just want change for the kids. La-da-da-da. La-da-da-da. Think about the kids. La-da-da-da. La-da-da-da. The kids. La-da-da-da. La-da-da-da. Listen to the kids. La-da-da-da. La-da-da-da. Yeah. Every day I hear the same song. Let bygones be bygones, they say. I say at what cost? If we forget the past, we gon' end up lost. This ain't history class, we're making history though. High fructose got us comatose. I tried to make a toast to the end of the globe, but no one's woke. Whoa, my heart's so heavy I couldn't float a boat. Thoughts for pennies got me thinking more than they pay me when you stream a flow. I'm on an island with all the kids that ain't buying what you selling. It's ironic you really killing the vibe with your guns and your Bibles. You must be crazy. Listen to the kids, bro. Save me. Real spit. Real, real spit. Mess around and start thinking about the kids. I ain't trying to tell nobody how to live. I just want to see you live. La-da-da-da. La-da-da-da. Think about the kids. La-da-da-da. La-da-da-da. Listen to the kids. La-da-da-da. Yeah. La-da-da-da. Listen to the kids. La-da-da-da. La-da-da-da. I don't wanna wait to find my hope. I don't wanna pray to save my soul. I'ma come and take what's mine and I'm all. I'ma come and raise like tide when I flow. Let me be free. Free from the violence, free from police. Free like the mind of a newborn G. Free like the world with peace. Free like the world with peace. Eh. La da da da. La da da da. Whisper. La da da da. La da da da. Now yell it. La da da da. La da da da. Listen to the kid. La da da da. La-da-da-da. Think about the kids. La-da-da-da. Yeah. La-da-da-da. Listen to the kids. La-da-da-da. The kids.
Wow.
Thank you, thank you,
that was
thank you.
Amazing.
Thank you, so good.
This is my guitarist, Elon Wright.
Yeah.
Worldwide, Elon Wright, worldwide.
Thank you guys so much for being here. That was incredible. Did you guys like them?
Yeah.
Did all of you like them?
Everybody was feeling it. Yeah.
Everybody was feeling it. We were singing, we were dancing and clapping. All right. Thank you to everyone who tuned in. Thank you to all of you for being here. Thank you to everybody who made this happen. And we will see all of you next year.
All right.
Great job, guys. So good.